In this video, we will take a look at the milestones of the Green political influence in Europe. The Greens emerged as a new political force in the 1970s in several European countries following the development of the Green movement in other parts of the world.
In reality, the first Greens emerged in Australia and New Zealand. I think it's there where the name Green was used for the first time for a political movement. And very quickly it swapped over to Europe, and the first Green party with some institutional success was a group of Swiss Greens. So between the second half of the 70s and the first 80s, the Green movement began to grow in several parts in Europe. In general, we say when we look at the way they, or what was behind the emergency of the Greens, it's clear that environmental preoccupation and protection was the key issue, but it was not the only one. It was also the women's right, it was the problem of peace and disarmament, it was the problem of solidarity with the Third World.
Along with the emergence of the Green parties in Europe, the first direct elections at the European Parliament took place in 1979. On this occasion, the coordination of European Green and Radical parties, CEGRP, was set up to coordinate the participation of these parties in the European elections, although no Green in this instance entered the Parliament. Soon after, though, a range of new Green parties were founded.
In the 80s were found the German Greens, probably the most important at that time, but at the same time the Greens emerged in Belgium and the Netherlands.
In 1984, the restructured European Green Coordination, EGC, was set up with a secretariat, provided by the Dutch political party of Radicals. The first Green members of the European Parliament were elected and formed the Green Alternative European Link, GRAEL Group, in the European Parliament.
As the Greens were not able to build their own fraction, they looked around with whom they can cooperate, and they made an agreement with the regionalists at the time and with the People's Party from Denmark. So they created a political fraction according to the laws, the requirements of the European Parliament. For the Greens at the time, the activities as activists, as militants on the street, on the protest movement, the rallies, participating in rallies, organizing rallies, etc., was as important or even more important than being represented in institutions. Even in institutions, they organized rallies.
Some of our staff from the early years, who started with me when I was an assistant, are working with us until today. Some have left. And so thinking back, I also would say it's admirable what we made out of these first possibilities to enter into the European Parliament.
In 1989, the Greens saw great success in the European elections, which enabled them to form the first Green group in the European Parliament. This group consisted of 30 members from Germany, Belgium, the Netherlands, France, Italy, and Portugal. In the context of this period, the group established its policy priorities central to a green agenda: climate change, environment, health, and peace. Alongside these, the Greens supported further European integration after the fall of the Iron Curtain and pursued a pro-European approach to social and environmental issues.
It was a very strong movement we organized from the European Parliament, but with the participation of all the parties, national MPs, local MPs and movements, students, young Greens, etc. This led to a kind of political understanding that was very impressive. Even their studies showing that beyond all our fights, because there were fights, and beyond all the misunderstandings among Greens, the Green group in the European Parliament was the most homogeneous group, politically speaking. It was the group who voted together in the most coherent way compared to the other political groups.
In 1994, The Green Group got reinforcements with the first Green MEPs from Luxembourg and Ireland, and in 1995 from Austria, Finland and Sweden. At this time, the Greens staged a spectacular protest against French nuclear tests on Mururoa.
For the Greens, I think it's crystal clear, at least in Germany or in Austria, this anti-nuclear battle laid the fundament for a new party. The old parties existing so far did not at all cover the concerns of the citizens, and the Greens were necessary in these days. It was so also a fight on what citizens have to say when it comes to decisions like construction of nuclear power plant, because such a decision matters a lot, not only for a short time, but for a very, very long period. The whole discussion of nuclear waste and that we have no good solution to deal with the nuclear waste was really also feeding and fueling the movement against nuclear.
By 1999, the Greens had achieved great representation in the European Parliament. They joined the European Free Alliance, a group composed out of regionalist and democratic nationalists, thereby establishing the fourth largest group in the European Parliament at the time. During the same year, Greens entered national governments in 5 out of 15 EU countries, and the first Green Commissioner, Michaela Schreyer from Germany, was elected into the European Commission with the responsibility for budget and anti-fraud. Climate change stayed at the heart of green policies, with a memorable campaign against the new Bush administration in the US in 2001 and a call to boycott US oil companies that blocked any measures against climate change. Greens were also very active in the development of the Charter of Fundamental Rights and in the European Convention, which led to the draft constitution for Europe. Another important milestone for European Greens was the establishment of the European Green Party, EGP, in Rome in 2004, as the first political party to lead a common pan-European election campaign. In addition, since 2007, FYEG has been the European Party's youth wing, gathering young green activists, movements and organizations across Europe. 1 year later, the European Green family grew further with the addition of the Green European Foundation, GEF. Modeled on many successful national green political foundations, the GEF was founded in order to encourage European citizens to participate in political discussions and to ultimately forge a stronger, more participative European democracy.
So the purpose of the foundation is also to raise the interest of green actors on European issues and European politics. So in order to fulfill that, we decided the best choice was to go outside Brussels and to meet people on the ground in the different member states. We try to reach the young green activists. Firstly, they are the future of the green movement. Second, they are not in the bubble, the Brussels bubble, or in the institutional settings of the green movements.
In 2009, the Greens launched the Common European Election Campaign, a Green New Deal for Europe, focused on proposing a green alternative for the European economy. Since then, they have actively promoted progressive and sustainable solutions to the issues faced by the European Union. Since the last European elections in 2014, the Greens, EFA, have held 50 seats in the European Parliament with members from 17 countries and 5 regions. They work to deliver concrete results for European citizens on key issues such as environmental protection and mitigation of climate change, transparency and democracy, tax justice, fair jobs, social justice and solidarity, and a sustainable economy.
There is clearly a one priority of the Greens which makes us different from the others. And this is our concern not only for the environment, but for the ecological system, for the whole of the earth, with nature and with the citizens. And I think the biggest battle we have ahead, and we made already some good steps, is the battle to protect the climate. And so a good climate strategy for the Greens is really about this demanding task to act now and here to protect the environment, the climate, the citizens, not now, but in the future, and not here, but everywhere.